This conference will now be recorded.
Hello. Sir.
Yes, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So today's topic is nutritional anemias. So what is nutritional anemia? Number 15 15. Hello. Number 20. Number 20. Roll number 25. Roll number 25. Roll number 25.
Present, sir.
నేను ప్రెసెంట్ కాదు అడిగేది. What is nutritional anemia?
It's due to deficiency of B12.
Deficiency of
vitamin B12 and folic acid.
That is nutritional anemia, na?
No, sir.
Roll number 50. Roll number 50. Bala Mukesh. Bala Mukesh. Sweta, 15.
Yes, sir.
Chepamma nutritional anemia ante enti? Indaka nenu call chesthe itla 15 number ani pilisthe ఎందుకు మాట్లాడాలా? చెప్పమ్మా న్యూట్రిషనల్ అనీమియా అంటే ఏంటి?
అనీమియా డ్యూ టు న్యూట్రిషనల్ డెఫిషియన్సీస్.
న్యూట్రిషనల్ వాట్ డెఫిషియన్సీ? న్యూట్రిషనల్ డెఫిషియన్సీ అంటే రోజు తినే ఫుడ్డా, రైసా, చపాతీయా, ఇంకేం తింటే, ఏం తింటే వస్తుంది, ఏం తగ్గితే తగ్గితే వస్తుంది వాటిల్లో.
Minerals are iron deficiency anemia, megaloblastic anemia, vitamins.
గట్టిగా చెప్పమ్మా, ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ అనీమియా చెప్పావు, గుడ్. ఇంకేమే? మెగాలోబ్లాస్టిక్
మెగాలోబ్లాస్టిక్ అనీమియా.
ఓకే గుడ్ మెగాలోబ్లాస్టిక్ ఎనీమియా వచ్చే రీజన్ ఏంటి
విటమిన్ బి 12 డెఫిషియన్సీ
అండ్
ఫోలిక్ యాసిడ్ డెఫిషియన్సీ
వెరీ గుడ్ మరి ఎందుకు నేను 15 నెంబర్ పిలిస్తే మాట్లాడలేదు ఓకే గుడ్ సో న్యూట్రిషనల్ ఎనీమియా ఇస్ ఎనీమియా మోస్ట్ కామన్ ఇన్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఈస్ ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ ఎనీమియా అమంగ్ ద న్యూట్రిషనల్ ఎనీమియాస్ ద మోస్ట్ కామన్ ఇస్ ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ అనీమియా ద అదర్ థింగ్ ఇస్ మెగాలోబ్లాస్టిక్ ఎనీమియా సో వాట్ డూ యూ థింక్ ద కామన్ ఏజ్ గ్రూప్ దట్ ఈస్ యూ కామన్లీ ఎఫెక్టెడ్ ఎంటైర్ చైల్డ్హుడ్ ఆర్ సర్టన్ ఏజ్ గ్రూప్స్ వేర్ న్యూట్రిషనల్ ఎనీమియా ఈస్ మోర్ కామన్ రోల్ నెంబర్ 45 రోల్ నెంబర్ 45 those who respond will be labeled as present those who don't respond I will be noting down they will be absent okay 45 even right or wrong is not a matter you have to respond roll number 45 okay 45 is absent Anisha
Yes sir
What is the common age where nutritional anemias are more common
sir generally the lower age group
low means
the preschool what children
Amma
the preschool children
yeah yeah very good preschool children means up to how many years of age
So 1 to 3 years.
Very good. So infancy is less than 1 year. 1 to 3 years is preschool. So sometimes some they will say up to 4 years also, but usually 3 years. So this is the common age group where nutritional anemia is more common. Why do you think nutritional anemia is more common in this age group? Roll number 12. One 11, BB Jan.
Yes, sir.
Why do you think nutritional anemia is more common in toddler age group?
Because usually toddlers they won't eat properly, sir, by feeding, and at the same time the mothers who are feeding the child. Usually by breast milk when they give breast milk they are already women are less nourished sir
okay
and availability of food poverty is one of the cause sir. Due to this poverty there are usually they usually take less amount of food which is less nutritious hence there is more chances of nutritional anemia sir
do you think having money at home is the only or not having no. money at home is the only reason or it is one of the reason
it is one of the cause sir
okay yeah good so actually even though they are not in poverty below poverty line these children may not eat properly and the mother doesn't know what diet to feed properly to get all these nutritions at in sufficient amounts and that too this age group they are very much fussy 1 to 3 years actually they are very much playful and they will not concentrate on eating and it will take very long time for mother also to feed and one more important reason is after 6 months of age when
increase the demand is sir for what, nutrition what? Increased demand and decreased appetite is also present
the,
sir in the
yeah, yeah, growth is one of the that too fast growth will be there in the initial period and improper what you call complementary feeding what is complementary feeding
along with the breast milk and we give foods we give food sir like rice along with the breast milk
Yeah, good. So it complementary feeding is in supplementation or along with. We should not stop breastfeeding. Breastfeeding should be continued, but breastfeeding will not be sufficient to provide enough energy and calories or proteins and all these things in sufficient amounts for the growth, sufficient for the growth of the child. We have to complement with small quantities of food. Okay, so that is usually started from 6 months of age. Okay, and we'll be continuing, and by 1 year of age, child should be able to eat whatever is being cooked at home. The child should be eat from the family pot. Okay, this is complementary feeding. So in complementary feeding also, we may not be able to provide enough quantities of minerals and vitamins, so that nutritional anemia is more common among this age group also. 6 months to 1 year is also common, but much more common is 1 month to, because if we don't supplement 6 months to 1 year, whatever resources are there till then will be completely exhausted. And from 1 year to 3 years of age is the most common age group where they will be keeping everything in mouth and they can get infested with parasites. Okay, and they can get anemia due to blood loss and iron deficiency. Nutritional causes iron deficiency anemia, and this one vitamin B12, megaloblastic, folic acid is also. Megaloblastic anemia is more common in this age group. Okay, so which is more common, Harika? Nutritional in nutritional anemia, which do you think, iron deficiency is more common or megaloblastic is more common? Harika, 29. Harika, Harika absent.
Sir.
Cheppamma. Are you able to hear me?
Sir, sir.
Are you able to hear me? Harika?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in nutritional anemia, iron deficiency and megaloblastic anemia are there. What is most yes. common in children? Which is more common in children, iron deficiency or megaloblastic anemia?
Iron
deficiency anemia. Good. Can there be both iron and megaloblastic anemia in single child, same child?
Yes, sir. It can be both.
Okay, good. Shweta has answered. Okay. Okay, we shall start. Okay. So nutrition anemia occur due to deficiency of one or more essential nutrients required for the synthesis of hemoglobin. What is required for synthesis of hemoglobin? Usually iron, vitamin B12, folic acid, vitamin C and vitamin E, proteins, because heme component and globin both are proteins. It is just iron which goes and binds with this protein and make it into hemoglobin. One second. So vitamin C, vitamin E and proteins. So iron deficiency is most common cause of anemia worldwide. and commonly occur in periods of increased requirement, that is infancy, adolescence also, and pregnancy. Nutritional anemia due to folic acid deficiency is more common than B12 deficiency. Okay. In megaloblastic also, folic acid deficiency is more common than vitamin B12 deficiency. So, what are the causes for iron deficiency anemia? Rule number 40.
Sir.
What are the causes of iron deficiency anemia? List out four or five causes.
Decreased iron stores in preterm.
Decreased iron
stores reserve.
Okay, that is the increased utilization. Okay.
Increased iron iron losses.
Loss. Iron losses. Okay. How iron is getting lost?
GI bleeding.
Okay.
Any infection, hookworm infections.
Okay. Okay. Any ulcerations and
peptic
bleeding.
Ulcers and.
So what else? What are the other causes? First of all, decrease intake, no?
Yes, sir. Decrease intake or decrease assimilation of iron.
So, reduced absorption, increased requirement, increased losses, and inadequate transport. Okay? So, reduced absorption, non-breastfed infants on cow's milk. Cow's milk, iron absorption is difficult. Whatever little iron is present in mother milk is easily absorbed. Inadequate intake of nutrients in diet. Malabsorption of iron in cases of chronic diarrhea, celiac disease, gastrointestinal surgery. Malabsorption. So reduced absorption in all these cases. Increased requirement, that is during periods of growth, that is fast periods of growth is less than initial 3 years, and again pubertal growth spurt in adolescence period, like around 13 to 15 years of age to 16 years. So this is the adolescent growth spurt will occur in this age group, so that then requirement will be high. Pregnancy and lactation, uniformly everyone knows that requirements will be increased. Losses, just now said, increased GI bleed due to secondary to hookworm infestations or due to gastritis, gastric ulcers, or due to portal hypertension and esophageal to gastric varices which bleeds. And another thing is inadequate transport, that is atransfer anemia. Transferrin is a, what is transferrin? Roll number 20.
Yes, sir.
Roll number 20.
Yes, sir.
What is transferrin?
It is a transport protein, sir.
Yeah, good. Transport protein that transfers
iron into the liver.
Good, very good. So into storage form in iron in liver, how it will get stored? What is the storage form of iron in body?
Fe2 plus.
Ferritin.
Ferritin.
Very good. So it will be transported to liver and it will be stored as ferritin, and this ferritin will be utilized by our bone marrow erythroblast cells, which have receptors on them, to uptake this ferritin and incorporate into hemoglobin. Okay, that incorporation of iron into hemoglobin will occur in the bone marrow synthesis. Liver is the storehouse of storehouse of this ferritin. Okay, so and anti-transferrin receptor antibodies that destroys this transferrin protein. So what is the pathophysiology of iron deficiency? Iron plays major role in formation of HP. Dietary iron occurs in two forms, animal and plant source. Animal is heme iron, plant source is non-heme iron, absorbed in ferrous form, mostly in the duodenum. Okay, first part of the duodenum. That too, what is the vitamin which increases iron absorption?
Vitamin C, sir.
Vitamin C, good. So absorbed in ferrous form, mostly in duodenum, and to lesser extent in jejunum and proximal ileum. From intestinal lumen, it is transported with a divalent metal protein across the mucosal border to enterocyte. From enterocyte into the blood and binding to transferrin, it will be transported to liver. Okay, so from enterocyte, it reaches the plasma by specific transporter protein called ferroportin, mediated by hepcidin. Okay, so after this transportation from enterocyte into plasma, it will be binding to transferrin. Okay, so from lumen to enterocyte, it is the divalent metal protein which helps in crossing from lumen site into the enterocyte. From enterocyte into the plasma, it is the ferroportin which is mediated by hepcidin. This is the specific transporter protein. After iron out of the cell into the blood, it will be binding to transferrin. Okay, so what extra whatever it is there will be going to liver, and if it is pure iron deficiency, immediately it should go for bone marrow for through erythroblasts that have receptors for iron transferrin complex, and it enters the endocytosis into the cell there for hemoglobin synthesis. If there is no iron deficiency and enough iron stores are there, you are giving more than enough iron, then it will get into storage form in the liver. Only 10% of dietary non-heme iron is absorbed. So from plant sources, the iron what we take is less. From animal sources, it is more. Altered by dietary factors like foods rich in vitamin C, calcium, it will decrease. Calcium will decrease absorption of iron. Vitamin C will increase absorption of iron. Okay, and tannin, that is in tea, all this will reduce. So we should not advise iron in children with milk, because milk may contain calcium and phosphorus. Okay, so we should not advise them along with milk. Okay, multivitamin drops with vitamin C we can advise. And we should give in empty stomach or with food iron? Rule number 30.
Empty stomach, sir.
Empty stomach. Why?
In the presence of acid, absorption increases, sir.
In the presence of acid, the ferrous form is easily absorbed. Okay, yes, very sir. Good. It is the acidic environment which is required for absorption of iron. So empty stomach is better, or if it is not possible, in between the meals. Meals means if a child takes a meal at around 11 o'clock, again the child takes meal at 3 o'clock, you can give it around 1 o'clock in between. Okay, like that, in between the meals we can give.
Yes, sir.
Clinical manifestation. Children with iron deficiency anemia, what clinical manifestation do you anticipate? Tell me at least 2-3 clinical manifestation in iron deficiency anemia, or just anemia. Roll number 45. Roll number 45. 45 absent. Roll number 50. Roll number 50. 50 absent. 52. 52 absent. 55. 55 absent. 56. 60.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So tell me,
there will be easy fatigability, shortness of breath.
Okay. What is the early sign? Early sign of anemia. Early sign. Easy.
Fatigability.
Easy fatigability. So usually they cannot do or perform a work similar to other children, and it easily they will become fatigued. What else can happen?
There will be shortness of breath.
Can be there. Good. Okay. On exertion.
Yes, sir.
Little exertion also they can have shortness of breath. If it is prolonged, can they have any mental disturbances?
Yes, sir.
Excessive irritability can be there.
Irritability, yes.
Okay, and psychological problems can occur. And yes, intellectual sir. Problems can occur. If it is very much prolonged and chronic iron deficiency, what can happen? Heart, what can happen to heart?
Tachycardia,
very good. And heart failure, can it occur or not with chronic iron deficiency anemia?
Yes, sir.
So chronic, it can happen. Congestive cardiac failure. Okay. So yes. children with iron deficiency anemia gradually present with symptoms depending on rate of fall of Hb. If it is rapid fall, child may go into hypotension and all these things. If it is gradual fall, he will be acclimatizing to that low hemoglobin levels. Initially pallor, but pallor itself may not be sign of iron deficiency anemia completely or anemia completely. There may be other reasons for pallor, but with in absence of other reasons, pallor is a sign of anemia. So we should look into the palms. We should look into the lower conjunctiva, okay, lower eyelids, and uniformly lips, appearance of the body we should see. Pallor, easy fatigability, anorexia means complete, they will not have any appetite. Okay, so first thing when we are treating iron deficiency anemia, first thing you written is appetite. And irritability may be noticed. Hyperdynamic circulation may lead to palpitations, shortness of breath, decreased exercise tolerance, and congestive cardiac failure. Okay. Mild degree of hepatosplenomegaly may be present for compensatory increase in production of cells, means extramedullary hematopoiesis. Hepatic means liver and spleen may increase in size. Okay. Raised intracranial pressure with papal edema may be seen. Frontoparietal bossing. What is frontoparietal bossing? Roll number 62. Roll number 49. 62 absent. Roll number 49. Manoj Reddy.
49 present, sir.
Present kaadu. What is frontoparietal bossing? What is frontoparietal bossing? Roll number 70. Roll number 70. 72. 70 absent. 72. 72. 72 absent. 74. 74. 74 absent. 76.
76.
Because of
medullary hematopoiesis, sir. Compensatory medullary hematopoiesis, sir.
Yeah, in medulla for compensation there will be increase in what you call diploic space. Okay, that space will be increased due to increase in bone marrow hyperplasia. For compensatory, increase in production of erythrocytes. Okay, and improperly with hypochromic or in megaloblastic macrocytes production. Okay, that is in chronic long standing iron deficiency anemia, it happens, and there will be increase in frontal prominence and parietal prominence, that is called as frontoparietal bossing. Non hematologic manifestations like choelonychia. What is choelonychia? 76. What is choelonychia?
Spoon shaped, sir.
Spoon shaped nails, good. Platinychia? Platinychia? Spoon shaped nails, bane undi ikkada. Ee mar platinychia pettaledu nenu cheppu.
Sir, flattening of the nails from this side, sir.
Yeah, flat nails. Okay, glossitis means
inflammation of the tongue
and stomatitis, mouth, oral cavity. Okay, so these are the non-hematologic manifestations. Did you heard of Plummer-Vinson or Patterson-Kelly syndrome?
Yes.
Sir.
Heard of?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So formation of mucosal webs at pharyngo-esophageal junction. Okay, and there is difficulty in swallowing. I think in ENT also you would have heard of this. What is pica? Pica.
Eating of non-nutritious food.
Non-nutritious substance.
Craving and eating of non-nutritious substances like earth, dust, okay, mud, and chalk. And what else? Paint.
Paints, soil.
Yeah, good. So that is pica. That is due to, most probably due to iron deficiency anemia only. Usually it will happen in children, that to this preschool children. Lack of concentration, because iron deficiency leads to improper brain functioning also. So the normal hands look like this, pink. This is paler, so anemic. This here, this is the frontal bossing, prominence of frontal horn. Here parietal also, parietal area also will be prominent. So how do you investigate? What investigations do you want to do? Roll number 80. Roll number 80. 80 absent. 81.
Sir.
Cheppu. 81 cheppu. How do you investigate,
sir?
How do you investigate for iron deficiency anemia, suspected nutritional anemia? How do you investigate? What investigation you want to do?
Blood picture, sir.
complete blood picture. Okay, what you will see in complete blood picture?
Reticulocytes count.
Okay, you want to say reticulocyte count also. Okay, good. What else? What will happen to reticulocyte count?
It increases, sir.
It will increase. Okay. In complete blood picture, what you will see first thing?
Hemoglobin, sir.
Ah, very good. Hemoglobin tagutundi. What is mild? What is moderate? What is severe anemia?
If it is below.
WHO grading, latest WHO grading of iron deficiency or anemia, ipudu severe, mild, moderate, severe categories etla categorize chesaro 9th semester inge undi kada meek group lo 81 roll number 81 pettali. Okay sir WHO iron deficiency anemia open chesi what are the
okay sir
Okay, what else you will see in complete blood picture? Roll number 83. Satish Achyut arrived. 82. Satish.
Present, sir.
Chappu. How do you investigate anemia?
Complete blood picture, sir.
Adhe already cheppe said thano. 81 roll number 81 cheppe said. Complete blood picture. HB takku undadam ivanni cheppe said. What other iron things?
Ferritin level, sir.
Iron ferritin. డైరెక్ట్ ఫెరిటిన్ పంపించేస్తావా ఇంకేం లేదా కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ లో హిమోగ్లోబిన్ తప్ప
హిమోగ్లోబిన్ ఆర్బీసీ కౌంట్
ఓకే
పెరిఫెరల్ స్మియర్
ఓ వెరీ గుడ్ పెరిఫెరల్ స్మియర్ ఏం చూస్తావు పెరిఫెరల్ స్మియర్ లో
మైక్రోసైటిక్ ద సైజ్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆర్బీసీ సార్
మైక్రోసైటిక్ ఓకే ఇంకేముంది
మైక్రోసైటిక్ అండ్ హైపోక్రోమిక్ ఎనీమియా
హైపోక్రోమిక్ ఎనీమియా ఓకే వెరీ గుడ్ ఇంకా సివియర్ క్రానిక్ గా ఉంటే ఇంకేం షేప్డ్ సెల్స్ చూస్తావు సిగార్ షేప్డ్ సెల్స్ అండ్ అనైసోపాయిసైటోసిస్ కూడా రావచ్చు సివియర్ ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ ఓకే దట్ ఇస్ కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ ప్లేట్లెట్ కౌంట్ ఏం అవ్వచ్చు ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీలో
platelet count decreases sir
decrease avudda increase avudda thrombocytosis vastundi increase avudda reason ento kuda nu kuda group lo pettu
okay sir
inke em chestar test lo cbp lo na inke em chustu complete blood picture inga avala చెప్పాలి త్వరగా టైం అయిపోతుంది 10:30 వరకే క్లాస్
కంప్లీట్
బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ ఇంకేం ఉంటుంది నాయన ఫైనల్ ఇయర్కి వస్తారు ఎగ్జామ్ గోయింగ్
టోటల్ డబ్ల్యూబీసీ కౌంట్ సార్ డబ్ల్యూబీసీ కౌంట్ థ్రాంబోసైట్స్
ఓకే ఇంకేముంటేనాయనా రోల్ నెంబర్ 90 రోల్ నెంబర్ 90 యాబ్సెంట్ 91 యాబ్సెంట్ 93 93 94 absent. 95
present.
చెప్పమ్మా కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ ఇంకేం
చూస్తావు
చెప్పమ్మా కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ లో ఏం చూస్తావు తెలియకుండా ఫైనల్ ఇయర్ ఎగ్జామ్ ఏం రాస్తావమ్మా
స్టెయినింగ్ చూస్తాను సార్
పెరిఫరల్స్ మీరు ఆల్రెడీ చెప్పారమ్మా ఇంకే స్టెయినింగ్ డైరెక్ట్ స్టెయినింగ్ అని అసలు ఇంకా కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ లో ఇంకేమీ లేవా హెచ్పి అయిపోయింది పెరిఫరల్స్ మీరు చెప్పారు ఇంకా బేసిక్ థింగ్స్ ఇంకేమున్నాయి హెమటోక్రిట్ లేదా అమ్మా హెమటోక్రిట్ అంటే తెలుసా వాట్ ఈస్ హెమటోక్రిట్
సార్ ఎంసీవి ఎంసీహెచ్సి అవి చూస్తాం సార్
ఇండైసెస్ ఇండైసెస్ అని చెప్పాలి
బ్లడ్ ఇండెక్స్
ఇవన్నీ ఈ త్రీ ఇండెసెస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దాన్ని బట్టి మైక్రోసైటిక్ ఉందా మ్యాక్రోసైటిక్ ఉందా ఓకే మ్యాక్రోక్రోమికా హైపోక్రోమికా హైపర్ అనేది మనకు క్లియర్గా తెలుస్తుంది ఓకే ఆ ఇండెసెస్ చెప్పకుండా ఇంకే ఇండెస్లో మీరు కనీసం కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చరే చెప్పట్లేదు ఓకే ఇంకేం చేస్తారు సిపిపి అయిపోయింది నెక్స్ట్
సీరం ఫెరిటిన్
No, you want to see serum ferritin level, that is storage form of iron. Okay. ఎంతక అంటే తక్కువ ఉంటే ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ అంటాం సెరం ఫెరిటిన్ సెరం ఐరన్ లెవెల్స్ ఎంతకంటే తక్కువ ఉంటే ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ అని అంటాం చూపించాను ఒకసారి హింట్ నెక్స్ట్ స్లైడ్ కనీసం చూడను కూడా చూడలేదు ఎవరు వాట్ ఇస్ టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ 100 రోల్ నెంబర్ 100 రోల్ నెంబర్ 100 ఆబ్సెంట్ 100 99 99 చెప్పమ్మా టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ అంటే ఏంటి
ఇట్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ ఇన్ ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ ఎనీమియా సర్
వై వాట్ ఈస్ టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీని ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుద్దా తగ్గుద్దా అని ఫస్ట్ అడగల వాట్ ఈస్ ఐ టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద పర్సంటేజ్ సాచురేషన్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ ఇనిషియల్ గా డిస్కస్ చేసిన ప్రోటీన్ ఏంటమ్మా ట్రాన్స్ఫరిన్ ఎంత సాచురేట్ అయి ఉన్నది ట్రాన్స్ఫరిన్ అని దాన్ని బట్టి 100% ట్రాన్స్ఫరిన్ సాచురేట్ అయితే ఆల్రెడీ టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ విల్ బి వెరీ లెస్ 90% సాచురేట్ ఉంటే ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ 10 ఏ ఉంటుంది అదే ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీలో ట్రాన్స్ఫరిన్ లో 10% బైండ్ అయి ఉంటే 90% విల్ బి ద టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ సో దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఓకే సో కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ పిక్చర్ ఇట్ ఇంక్లూడ్స్ కంప్లీట్ బ్లడ్ కౌంట్ విత్ పెరిఫరల్ స్మియర్ దెర్ విల్ బి లో హిమోగ్లోబిన్ అండ్ హిమటోక్రిట్ విత్ రెడ్యూస్డ్ రెడ్ సెల్ కౌంట్ ఇది అందరూ చెప్పారు లో ఎంసీబీ ఎంసీహెచ్ ఎంసీహెచ్సి అండ్ ఇంక్రీజ్ రెడ్ సెల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ విత్ మైక్రోసైటిక్ హైపోక్రోమిక్ ఎనీమియా విత్ సిగ్నిఫికెంట్ ఎనైసోసైటోసిస్ అండ్ పాయిక్లోసైటోసిస్ అది కూడా చెప్పాను నేను సేరం ఐరన్ స్టడీస్ లో సేరం ఐరన్ లెవెల్ లెస్ దాన్ 40 మైక్రోగ్రామ్ పర్ డెసిలీటర్ ఉంటుంది టోటల్ ఐరన్ బైండింగ్ కెపాసిటీ 250 to 350 మైక్రోగ్రామ్ పర్ డెసిలీటర్ ఇస్ నార్మల్ ఇన్ ఐరన్ డెఫిషియన్సీ ఎనీమియా ఇట్ విల్ ఇంక్రీజ్ This is how a peripheral smear of iron deficiency, probably hypochromic micro, it will not indicate the cause, but it will show hypochromic microcytic anemia. So these are the normal erythrocytes. These are the hypochromic because central pallor is increased here central pallor is fine, some cells are fine, this is normal cell. So here the central pallor is more, and the size, if you compare, these cells are smaller than the normal cells. So it is hypochromic and microcytic. Okay, hypochromia means central pallor is more. Understood? Serum ferritin levels. This is the gold standard for evaluating iron status. Less than 12 nanogram per ml is highly specific for iron deficiency anemia. Can be evaluated in chronic disorders. Bone marrow will show, this is the last resort we will do. Bone marrow will show increased cellularity with micronormoblastic erythroid hyperplasia. Okay, micronormoblastic erythroid hyperplasia. We want that only, the response of the bone marrow. It will be normalized once you start supplementing iron. So treatment depends on severity and associated complications. Those with severe anemia and or congestive heart failure will require hospitalization and blood transfusion. Oral therapy, dose is 3 to 6 milligram per kg per day of elemental iron. Absorption is best when taken on empty stomach and in between the meals. Side effects, nausea, vomiting, epigastric discomfort, constipation and diarrhea. Reticulocyte count is expected to increase within, that is the first response, 72 to 96 hours of treatment. After completion of therapy, should be continued for another 2 to 3 months to replenish the stores, iron stores in the body. Understood? Parenteral therapy, whenever oral iron is not tolerated, we will give parenteral therapy. Malabsorption from the intestine cases and ongoing blood loss cases. Iron sucrose 1 to 3 milligram per kg diluted in 150 ml of NS and given as slow infusion for 30 to 90 minutes. Iron required, what is the mg required, we'll calculate weight into 2.3 into 15 minus patient's HB plus 500 to 1000 milligram additionally. Okay, so this is the iron requirement calculation. Megaloblastic anemia is characterized by presence of macrocytes in the blood and megaloblasts in the bone marrow. Common causes are folate deficiency or vitamin B12 deficiency or defects in their metabolism. Folic acid deficiency anemia, folates are not synthesized by our body. So depends on dietary sources for the requirement. These biological compounds are heat labile and water soluble, present in fruits, green leafy vegetables, liver and kidney. So vitamin B12 deficiency anemia, vitamin B12 is a water soluble vitamin, you already know, comprises of biological active cobalamins, methyl cobalamin and adenosyl cobalamin. They are essential for methylation of homocysteine to methionine and conversion of methyl melonyl CoA to succinyl CoA. They are critical to DNA, RNA and protein synthesis, very important. Rich source of vitamin B12 are animal proteins, meat, egg, fish. Daily requirement is 0.4 to 2.4 micrograms. What is the pathophysiology? Folic acid or pteroyl glutamic acid is not biological active, but reduced form tetrahydrofolate is biological active. So they are involved in formation of some pteroyl glutamic acid and hydrolyzed pteroyl glutamic acid in the mucosal cells of small intestine. For folic acid and vitamin B12 play an important role in purine and pyrimidine biosynthesis. This is very important. So, and folate deficiency results in reduced purine and pyrimidine biosynthesis and impaired DNA synthesis and cell division. Okay, and ineffective erythropoiesis. Causes, daily requirement is 100 to 200 micrograms. Anemia due to folate deficiency occur due to inadequate intake of foods rich in folate. Consumption of goat milk. Goat milk will contain deficient folate and it will cause antagonized folic acid absorption also. Excessive boiling and pasteurization result in 75% loss of folate. So we should not boil too much. And folate deficiency can occur in malabsorption syndromes and protein energy malnutrition. Metabolic causes like inborn error of metabolism in cobalamin deficiency, congenital intrinsic factor deficiency, methyl malonic aciduria, homocystinuria, inborn errors of folate metabolism like congenital folate malabsorption and dihydrofolate reductase deficiency. Intake of drugs like phenytoin or phenobarbital, methotrexate is anti-folate medication, and pyrimethamine, all these are anti-folate, causes folate deficiency. Intake of drugs, proton pump inhibitors, will cause impaired cobalamin absorption. Aminosalicylate and metformin, neomycin interfere with cobalamin metabolism. ribonucleic nucleotide reductase inhibitors like hydroxyurea, cytarabine, arabinoside also will are antagonists. Purine analog 6-mercaptopurine, thiogabine, azathioprine, these are all anti-cancer drugs. Clinical manifestation, body stores are sufficient for only 4 months, and anemia due to folate deficiency usually occurs from 4 to 7 months of age, much earlier than iron deficiency. Preterm infants are at higher risk of developing folate deficiency due to inadequate folate stores. They usually present with irritability, poor feeding, and growth retardation. Several studies have proved that folate deficiency during periconceptional folate period leads to neural tube defects. Combined folate and vitamin B12 deficiency in infants present with abnormal behavior and defective cognitive and motor function. So combined deficiency is very dangerous. Folate deficiency can occur during prolonged parental nutrition, anemia, anorexia, irritability, and easy fatigability. Features characteristically found in megaloblastic anemia include glossitis, color also will change, hyperpigmentation of skin or knuckles, terminal phalanges, enlargement of liver and spleen. Neurological signs may precede this anemia. Earliest neurological sign is loss of position and vibratory sense. Posterior columns, tell the dorsal columns and posterior and lateral column deficits may appear later. Memory loss, confusion, neuropsychiatric symptoms also will occur. Investigation, the peripheral smear will show macrocytic RBCs and anisopyclocytes and hypersegmented neutrophils. Neutropenia and thrombocytopenia occur in severe deficiency. Bone marrow aspiration is hypercellular with prominent megaloblastic changes and erythroid precursors. Normal serum folic acid level is 5 to 20 nanogram per ml. Deficiency less than 3 nanogram per ml. Normal RBC folate is 150 to 600 nanogram per ml. And in deficiency less than 50 nanogram per ml. So this is the normal picture. If you see the central pallor, it is present. Here central pallor is present and more, and it is macrocytic size. If you see these cells and these cells are and hyperchromic, they are here. If you compare here and here, it is little hyperchromic. This is what is this hypersegmented neutrophil. Serum vitamin B12 levels are low, and serum methylmalonic acid and homocysteine levels are elevated in B12 deficiency because these are the precursors which requires B12 for conversion, which is while in folate deficiency only serum homocysteine is increased. Excessive excretion of methylmalonic acid in the urine is a sensitive and reliable index of B12 deficiency. Schilling test, I think you heard of the Schilling test in pathology. Administration of vitamin B12 radio labeled followed by collection of 24-hour urine collection. Adequate absorption is suggested by detection of more than 7% of administered radioactivity in the urine. Repeating the test with co-administration of intrinsic factor differentiates between pernicious anemia and malabsorption. Treatment, folic acid 1 to 5 mg per day for 3 to 4 weeks is given. Initial response of folate therapy occurs within 72 hours. Diet with high folate content is recommended. Antifolate medication require reducing or discontinuing. B12 is administered at 250 to 100,000 microgram by intramuscular route. Younger children may require lesser dose. Therapy is given daily for 1 to 2 weeks and then weekly until hematocrit normalizes. Patient with pernicious anemia and malabsorption require lifelong administration because there is no chance of absorption in this pernicious anemia and malabsorption cases. Patient with neurological manifestation should reduce more dose. That is 1000 microgram daily for 2 weeks, then every 2 weeks for 6 months and monthly for life. Okay, thank you.